Hey guys, this is Bhushan and today I gonna tell you how to use ultrasound distance sensor using Arduino Uno board. So before that, we need to know the basic of this sensor. Now this sensor uses the ultrasound and receive the echo. On that echo, we need to calculate the distance of that obstacle. So first we need to know about the basic of that sensor. So let's see how we can do this. We know the Arduino Uno board. So now here I'm using Arduino Uno board. So let's see how the distance sensor works. So here we can see how that ultrasonic distance sensor work. So in ultrasonic distance sensor, we have one sound emitter and the second one is the receiver. So as the first, when that sensor emits the sound, and we know the sound travels 340 meter per second, or we can say 1 centimeter per 29 microseconds, then how we can calculate this value, that's 29 microseconds. And we know the distance sensor uses a two-way trip, means one it emits the sound and then it gets the reflected echo and it calculates the distance of that obstacle. So now how we can calculate this distance from the time? So we know distance equal to speed into time. And we know 1 second equals to 1000000 microseconds. So if we consider 340 meter per second, by calculating we will get 0.034 centimeter per microsecond. So to make 1 centimeter, we required 0.034 into 29, it's nearly equals to 1, you know, equals to 0.986 we get. And suppose if we multiply 0.034 into 30, we will get I think 1.2 something like that. But we required the whole figure or the value which is very near to 1 centimeter. So here we are using 29. So 0.034 into 29 will get 0.986 and it's very near to 1 centimeter. So once we get the number 1 centimeter, we can convert it into distance easily. To convert the microsecond to centimeter, we required to divide the time received, means by the sensor we received some time, so we need to divide time received by 29, what we get early, and the whole result will be divided by 2 because it's a two-way trip. So we require to divide it by 2 and we will get the distance. And now we see how we can implement this calculation in the program. So I have this sensor. This is the ultrasound distance sensor. So I have 4-pin sensor. So the first pin is VCC, then trigger, then echo and ground. So to use this pin on the board so we can connect it in an easy manner, so we need to configure some pin as per our requirement. So this is my arrangement. So I directly connect this sensor on the board. So to connect it directly, you need to configure some pin. So let's see how we can configure that pin as per our requirement. So as we know, the first is the setup. So here in pin mode 2, I configured it as output, then 5, 8 and 10. So as per the diagram, we can see here. So I use the pin number 2, 5, 8, and 10 for output. And as usual, I set the baud rate for 9600. And then in loop, I use this digital write pin number 2 to high, because we have this 2 number pin for VCC, so I keep it in high mode. Then I use 3 variables. First one is duration, then inches and centimeter. Then I keep the pin number 2 on as an output for triggering purpose. Then to create the beep, one short and one long, I use a digital write pin number 3 to low for with the delay of 2 microsecond, and again I keep that pin in a high, means I change the low pin number 3 from low to high, and then again I give a delay of 5 microsecond, and then again I change that pin number 3 to low, so to create the beacon. So in pin mode number pin number 4, I keep that pin number 4 in a input mode, and then I receive the duration from pin number 4, because we know pin number 4 is so I use the pin number 4 for echo. Pin number 4 for echo. So on pin number 4, I can receive echo. So I keep that input in duration, and then once I get the duration, then I can change that duration into centimeter and inches. So let's see how we can convert the duration into centimeter. So here is the function microsecond to centimeter. So as we know, it's a two-way trip. So I got the result in microseconds. So I divide that microsecond by 29 and the whole value by 2, and it returns that value, whatever the value we get calculated, it returns to here. So here we get the exact distance in centimeter. Now we can write the program, means if we get the obstacle, then we can glow the LED, means as per our requirement we can change the program. So here I give the condition, if centimeter is less than or equals to 50, means I'm checking for 50 centimeter. If any obstacles come under the range of 50 centimeter, then it will glow the LED. So I write centimeter is less than equals to 50, then digital write high. So I connect LED on pin number 8 and 10. So as soon as it get the obstacle, it will turn the LED which is connected on pin number 8 to high, and the LED which is on 10, it converted to low. Else, if we didn't get any obstacle, then it's keep the pin number 10 to high, and the LED which is on pin number 8 to low. Now we can also print that value in inches and centimeter on screen, so we can easily show this output on serial monitor. So you can, once you connect your Arduino board on the computer, then you can easily see the values on serial monitor. So now let's see how this setup. So let's connect your Arduino board to the laptop or computer and compile the program. And if you found no errors in the program, then upload the program. Now we make the program for 50 cm. Now it's time to test our program is working fine or not. So first we need to check the connection. So here I use two LEDs. So one to show whether there is no obstacle, and one for the obstacle. So this LED is for if sensor detect no obstacle, and this is for sensor detects obstacle. Now see, so as soon as I keep my hands in front of sensor, it glows the second LEDs. So it means our program works fine. So we can change the distance and we get the output as per the requirement. So here this program is working fine for the 50 cm. So in the following way, we successfully build the program, we test the program with the hardware. So in next tutorial we will see how this program will be used in a robot building or obstacle avoidance robot. Thank you for the same.